Hey, Lady Fish. It's the 16th of June, 2018, and I'm sorry, but we have to go to NASA again, because this is what they do, all right? It's just this little article I saw here, and even at this little thumbnail, I could see the little devil in there. So, of course, you know, that gets me to go and check it out, and of course, it's right there. You might not be able to see it until I show it to you, but I'm going to get to my point here shortly. Here, let me just show this to you now, because I want to show you something different here, more important. So there's that same image, and if you just look right here, I mean, I'll show you something here. I put some little highlights in there. Okay, do you see them now? I mean, it's just ridiculous. In your face, ridiculous. You know, my drawing isn't the greatest, but that's what it is. There's absolutely no doubt. They love to just put it in your face, I'm telling you, folks. And there's a lot more in this image as well that represents a lot of things, but I thought I'd just show the obvious first, just to get the mood. You know, that NASA is literally nothing more than, you know, a front company, you could say, for satanic activity. I mean, that institution was like their cornerstone, more or less, of this great deception that they've had us under now for forever, really. I mean, you gotta start looking at things in a totally different way, you know, because this is a spiritual war, big time. So it starts off with that, but then I see this here, this Peggy Whitson retiring. This is all so pathetic, people. I'm just curious about this whole thing, the way this is worded. You know, it seems like, you know, her retirement is kind of like signaling something to me. That's kind of what it means. She was in space 665 days, which is an 11-11 and one shy of the magic 666. And anyway, it's just a very strange thing, very weird. In the very last paragraph, she talks about, "I'll miss seeing the enchantingly peaceful limb of our Earth from the vantage point. Until the end of my days, my eyes will search the horizon to see that curve." See, they're mocking you. Big time, all the time. That's what they do. They're just liars. So, of course, I had to go to NASA just to look at this stuff, you know what I mean? I can't help it. But wait till you see what came up. It's just the strangest thing. You could go to any one of these. I'm telling you, I did something, I think, yeah, on Apollo. We could pick almost any one of these, you guys. I'm not kidding. It's that simple. Oh, look at that one. There, okay? You can see it's so clear as day. I mean, it is just pathetic that there is just this demonic entity in there. You can just see it, right? So I'm poking around here. I want to pick a few of these things to show you guys. And I found one that was put up recently, well, at least the last couple of months, that surprised me. It really did. It's called The Pillars of Creation. And I've talked about these before in the past, because this is just mind-blowing. And I'm seeing this in a whole different way now. But I still need more understanding. I'm not exactly sure what it means. But wait till you see what I show you on this Pillars of Creation, okay, put up on February 22nd this year, and that struck me as weird. February 22nd, so I had to punch it into the calculator, you know what I mean? 2/2/2/18, and I put it up to the solstice, and check this out. Exactly 119 days, 9/11. Perfect. 3 months, 30 days, which is a rare thing. Signature of NASA right there, 33, and exactly 17 weeks. This is pretty interesting to me, and I don't understand why this came into my view today, but here it is. And this image right here, this is an official NASA image, the towering tendrils of cosmic dust, M16 Eagle, blah blah blah, pillars featured in this stunning Hubble image. Okay, this is an official Hubble image right here. You need to understand this, I'm sorry, but try and see what I'm showing you. The Pillars of Creation. This is what NASA produces for the public. and tells them this is a space nebula hundreds of light years away. Okay? Just remember that. And this is that image. Okay? Now, I need you to really think about this. I'm just saying. If we look at this section of this image, I just need to ask you, what do you see right there? I want you to just look in that area. Do you not see the profile of an infant, a baby, a young child? There's the top of the head. Comes to a point right there. Forehead, little eyelid even right there. There's a little chubby little baby cheek, right? There's even a little baby ear. I hope you can see that because I ain't drawing anything in it because I don't think it's necessary. That is a little cherubim. That's a little devil baby. A little fallen one because it has wings. See that? You cannot make this up and you cannot miss that. It's got wings and he's got one wing extended like a hand and he's joined hands with this character, okay? This is just crazy, you guys. This is like a fallen angel making the deal with the devil, okay? And they have something clasped in their hands that doesn't belong there. Can you see this guy, by the way? Look at that face. You can literally see it. It's like one of those really spooky clown face kind of faces. Man, this is just their representation. This is how it manifests out through this craziness. But that little cherubim right there is, that you gotta admit, that is freaky beyond understanding. And here it is in an official NASA image. Of course, I'll link this. And he is shaking hands. It's as though there's a deal being made. Is this showing us how they fell? When they fell? The third of the angels going with Satan? Are they making the deal right here? I'm not really clear on this. And I'm not really clear on why I'm seeing this today. But there it is, you guys. Pillars of creation. You got a little baby angel, more or less, shaking hands or exchanging something with this demon. Because that's what that is, you guys. His eye there is a little... That's a creepy looking dude right there with the little angel baby. Isn't that just the craziest, freakiest thing you might have ever saw in the Eagle Nebula? And it's not all that's there either. This is what they do to us people, okay? This is how in your face they love to put this stuff. Look at over here. Little fox hiding in the shadows there, little creature, right? Look at this guy. Magician. Sorcerer. He's got the fez cap, everything on, right? This is not a joke. Look at this. I believe this is even a watcher or something up there. And it goes on, you guys. There's detailed stuff that I'm not even going to get into showing you. This is without even drawing anything on here. That is off the hook. I can't help it. You know? You show this stuff to these people. Most people just, oh, quiet, you silly, uneducated, non-PhD citizen. You're just stupid and mad because you don't know math like we do. And they just laugh it off. And look at that. The spirit of Satan put that in there, people. That's the only way that that gets there. It's the spirit of Satan. Courtesy of NASA. Links in description. I had to show you that. What does that mean to see that now? Huh? 119 days before the 21st. 33. 17. All of it. That's crazy. But I had to show it to you. And anyway. There you go, people. Keep seeking Jesus, you know? Seriously. It's just getting so close. You need him. You need him. Alright? Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,